Hello everyone, I want to welcome everyone watching this video on my channel and also on this complete C programming tutorials. In this tutorial, you will learn C programming from very basic to really advanced. So let's start. So this is part 6 and I'll be telling about preprocessor directives. So if you are new to this channel, please subscribe my channel and also watch all its previous part. I have provided the link in the description. So before talking about preprocessor directives, let's get cleared out what is preprocessor. So preprocessor are a special type of processor that process the program before the actual processing. Now let me make you more clear. So at first we will be writing the source code. So what after source code? That is execution process. So at the beginning of the execution process there comes compilation. But before the actual compilation starts, there comes preprocessor. Now what does this preprocessor do over here? So here, this preprocessor will convert the source code into complete C program. That means it will remove all the comment, as we don't require comment for compilation. Furthermore, it also copies the code written in header file to the main file. So after the comments are removed and the codes of header files are copied, then it goes for compilation and then execution. So let's come up with preprocessor directives. So what are preprocessor directives? Preprocessor directives are the special statements which are executed at the beginning of a compilation process, which I already said, and these are placed before main function in a program. These all preprocessor directives begin with a symbol hash and don't require a semicolon at the end. So now it looks familiar. So what we used to do in every program, we would be linking the library file into our main program by just using a code that is hash include and stdio.h. So what's this then? It's a preprocessor directive. But we never knew that hash include stdio.h was called preprocessor directive. So I have listed some preprocessor directives which we often use in C programming language, which are hash include, hash define, hash if def, hash if and def, hash ondef, if, else, elif, and indef. So these are the preprocessor directives we use in C programming language. So I will be demonstrating few of them. Let's start with include. So there's no program where we don't require this hash include preprocessor directive. So what's the main work of it? This hash include is used to paste the code of given header file to the current file. I have already said what are header files and I had also showed you the content of header files. So this hash include copies the content of that header file to your file, that is where you are programming. And the next one is define. This hash define is often used for symbolic constant or defining a macro. Similarly, ifdef and ifandef are used as conditional statement. And ondef is used for undefining a defined macro. And on the right hand side, that is if, else, elif, and indef. These all work as conditional statement. So let's open our dev C++. I closed all the document and created a new one. So at the very beginning, I'll be giving it a title using comment, that is / and asterisk. So I'll be naming it as demonstration 2. Preprocessor directives. So preprocessor directives. So here it is. Let's close the comment using asterisk and / or we could have used double / at the beginning over here. The spelling of demonstration is wrong. Over here I corrected it. So it's our documentation section. What is it? It's documentation section. So what after documentation section? That's link section. So I'll be using here include stdio.h. So what is this then? It's a link section and this stdio.h is header file, but this hash and include is a preprocessor directive. So don't get confused. The whole statement is a link section and this stdio.h is header file and only this hash include is preprocessor directive. So I'll be mentioning it here, only hash include is a preprocessing directives, preprocessor directives. So what does this do? let me first write a main function over here. Let's keep curly braces and write printf, and let's display welcome and a semicolon at last. So in this program, how does this printf work? This works because of stdio.h. So for example, if we remove this, let's comment it out and let's save the program. Let's name it demo1 because we already have demo, and let's compile it. So as we compile, this gives error. So there's a great role of stdio.h for the execution or smooth running or proper running of this printf statement. So as this is a preprocessor directive, this gets executed before the actual compilation. Now what will preprocessor do over here? Now the preprocessor will paste the code which is inside this stdio.h into this program before the compilation. And the preprocessor will also remove these comments because these comments are unexecutable. So similarly, we could also include other files like include stdlib standard library.h, and the full form of this stdio is standard input output. So there's a function in C language that is clrscr, clear screen, which clears the screen. So this code does not run in dev C++. So let's compile it. This gives an error. So instead of this clear screen function, we can use its alternative, that is system and bracket, and under bracket we write cls. And now when we compile it, it shows zero error. Let me demonstrate it. So let's write over here printf, and let's print hello world again. So let me also include a getcs function so that I can show you clearly. So let's save the program and let's compile and run the program. So here it is. So this prints the hello world and waits for a character. So as I type any character, it clears hello world and prints welcome. If we hadn't included this system CLS, then what would happen? Let's save the program and run and compile it. Compile and run it. So this will print hello world and wait for a character due to this get CS statement. As I enter any character, this will print welcome. So I think you understood what does this system CLS do. So let's close it. Again, let's remove these statements. So this is how you use include preprocessor directive. Similarly, we have other preprocessor directives that are as defined. So as I already said, these are also used for symbolic constant. Symbolic constant. Now what are these symbolic constant? Symbolic constant is a name that is used in place of a sequence of character. The character may represent numeric constant or a character constant or a string constant too. So let's do it. We have a very famous mathematical term that is pi, whose value is 3.141 approximately. So this pi is a symbolic constant which is used in place of this 3.141, and this defines this macro. So instead of this welcome, let's type here modulus f and let's print pi. Let's save the program and compile and run it. So this will print the value of pi, that is 3.141. You can see over here 3.141. So let's close it and let's see what does undef do. As undef. As I already said, this undef undefines the macro which we defined. So let's write here pi. Now let's save the program and compile the program. This will show us error that pi is not declared in this function. Why? Because we already undefined it over here using undef. So let's clear this undef and let's see some more examples of define. I write over here has defined and a constant called a with its value character capital A, and I remove this or replace this f with c and this pi with a, and let's save the program and compile and run it. So this will print capital A. So you can see over here capital A. So let's close it again and let's do some more interesting thing. So I type over here has defined. So let's write algebraic function, that is f fx, which is equivalent to 6x square plus 4x. So now let's ask user to enter the value of x, that is printf, and enter the value of x. So let's store it in a variable modulus t called a. So let's define over here too, or declare, it is a. So let's print here. The result is modulus d, and I write over here f a. So let's close this statement. Let's save it. So now what will this do? As this fx is a symbolic constant which we defined using hash define, so as the compilation starts, this fa will replace with 6a into a plus 4 into a. So let's compile and let's check. So here comes an error. So let me explain you why did this error occur. So over here we defined a constant, that is symbolic constant a. We know the value of constant a will never change. But we also defined a variable a over here. So how can a constant and a variable have same name, that is a and a? So let's remove this statement, or let's comment it, because comment is not going to execute. So let's save the program again and compile it. So it says 0 error. Now let's run the program. Now it asks us to enter the value of x. Suppose I enter 1. Now if I replace this x with 1, what will it be? 6 into 1 square plus 4 into 1, that will be 10. So as I press enter on my keyboard, this must display 10. It's taking a bit time. It did not display. Why is it so? So let's check our program. So over here we did not write ampersand, that is and symbol. So let's compile it again and run the program. So now as I type 1, this will display the result is 10. So let's close it. So in this way you can use this define preprocessor directive. So let's clear this out over here. So now let's see some examples of as if, as else, as elif, and as endif. So let's define a symbolic constant over here. Define a equals to 10, not equals to a space 10. So let's clear it out. I had already mentioned you that these preprocessor directives are written above main function, but these special preprocessor directive are written inside main function. So I write over here hash if, and I'll be checking a equals to 10. If this condition is true, then this must print suppose hello, hello, and a semicolon over here. So here we started this if, hash if. Now we must end this hash if using hash int if. So I write over here as endif. Now I save the program and compile it. Now here comes an error. The error occurred because we added a space over here which we should not be adding. Let's clear it over here too. Now let's save the program and compile and run it. So this printed hello. Let's close it again and let's change this value to 11. And let's write here, if a equals to 10, then this will print hello, or else this is going to print hi. So I'll be saving the program again and compile and run the program. So as this was not equals to 10, so it printed hi. So again let's use this elif. It's similar to else if. I'll send this else to elif, and I'll write here elif a equals to 11. This will print hi. And if both the condition doesn't satisfy, then this is going to print sorry, invalid. Let's just print sorry and give a semicolon over that. Now let's save it. Now let's compile and run the program. Now the value of A is 11. So this condition satisfied and this printed high. Now let's close this and let's change the value from 11 to 12. Now let's save the program and again compile and run it. So over here this value is neither equals to 10 nor 11. So this prints sorry. So this is how you use as if, as else, as elif and as endif. So this was all about preprocessor directives. Thanks for watching this video. And if you have any questions regarding this topic, you can comment it down. I will be really happy answering those questions. So if you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also click the bell icon to get notified about my future updates.